The Honourable Member for Minto.
Yesterday, students at Sturgeon Heights Collegiate and their parents were saddened and disappointed to hear their music program will be dramatically reduced this fall. Popular music teacher will be let go, and three performing groups, the Wind Ensemble, Jazz Combo, and a Jazz Band, will cease to exist. The explanation given to parents and students is that this cut comes as a result of the provincial government's choice to underfund the school division.
Wow.
Will the Minister of Education step in to ensure that this popular and successful program will not be slapped?
It's not too late.
The Honourable Minister of Education and Training.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. Our government has provided a record amount of funding for the K-12 system in this province of Manitoba. We are great fans of good education in this province, and we will continue to supply and encourage school divisions to work together to provide the services required so that students in Manitoba can have the best education possible. Under the previous government, our educational results went from number 5 in Canada to number 11.
Order. The Honourable Member for Minto on a supplementary question.
Madam Speaker, we believe the arts are an important part of quality education. The music program at Sturgeon Heights has a proud history going back decades to Silver Heights, which merged with Sturgeon.
Yep.
I took band at Silver Heights, and so did the Premier's predecessor as a PC leader. The music program at Sturgeon Heights is well known to the member for St. James as a former trustee, the member for Kirkfield Park, who's a graduate of Silver Heights, as well as the member for Assiniboia, whose constituency includes the school.
Hmm.
Even the finance minister used to make his living teaching music in a public school.
Wow.
Is there anyone in the PC caucus prepared to speak up and defend the music program at Sturgeon Heights?
The Honourable Minister of Education and Training.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. And I can assure the member that members of our caucus speak up in favour of education all the time. And our government is focused on making sure that Manitoba students have access to a good quality education province-wide. And we were certainly proud to be part of record funding for K-12 system in Manitoba. If the member opposite was so worried about our Manitoba education system, why did they underfund construction program for the last 10 years?
Order. The Honourable Member for Minto on a final supplementary.
This government can control the spin in this building, but they can't control the concern in our communities. My time in the music program included many talented musicians who went on to pursue careers in music. There's Alice, who teaches music at Westwood. There's Jim, who went to Brandon University and a career as a jazz musician and professor. And there's George, whose keyboards you would hear if you ever listened to Lenny Kravitz. And for everyone who went on to a career in music, there were many others who benefited from the discipline, the teamwork, and the development that comes from a successful music program. How many more arts programs will be reduced or closed down due to this government's funding choices?
The Honourable First Minister.
Madam Speaker, many members of this House, including the member for Fort Rouge, who I know had an exciting musical career, and many others. I have enjoyed my time with music in school and since, and I agree with the member in his assertions about building skills and about the opportunities for not only a music education, but a liberal arts education as an arts graduate myself as well. I think these are important aspects of how we give our young people the opportunity to grow and to learn. And so, and I particularly appreciate his reference to teamwork. And team building is something that I know can be put on display by a good government such as this one, and will. As we support education and improving the quality of education, Madam Speaker, within the constraints of the real inherited deficit and debt situation that we've been given by the previous government, we'll do our utmost to make sure that the best quality education and the best possible results for our young people are achieved.